The man behind the Revolutionary Front is the political secretary general, 26-year-old José Ramos Horta. Like Fretilin's president, vice president, and army commander, he trains for the Catholic priesthood and spent several years in a Jesuit seminary.
So if I understand Fretilin's policy accurately, you didn't really want independence now. You were going for independence at a much later date. Is this in fact a revolution which came about too soon?
What we always wanted from Portugal was the immediate recognition of the right to independence for the Timorese people. After such a recognition, Fretilin and the Portuguese government, together, we can work out a program which lead to independence in a few years' time.
The title, Fretilin, the Revolutionary Front, it sounds communist. Is it in fact communist?
Well, I have always reject strongly that Fretilin is a communist party. It is not. It is a front that unites all Timorese patriots, all nationalists, without discrimination of race, religion, of political belief. And being a front, we cannot start right in the beginning saying that we are communists. We, as a founder of Fretilin, I reject strongly any labels. Besides this, we are quite aware of our great responsibility in the maintenance of peace and stability in this area. We are quite anxious to accommodate ourselves to the political environment of the area with ASEAN and the Pacific countries like Australia, New Zealand, Fiji, and New Guinea. So, once again, I stress on behalf of Fretilin that we are not at all a communist party.
Are you yourself a communist?
No, I don't believe in totalitarian systems. I believe in democracy.
The UDT coup on August the 11th rather precipitated the whole independence movement. With 90% of the population in Eastern Timor illiterate, do you think that at the moment you are really ready for independence?
Well, any country is, any colony is always ready for independence, because we believe that independence is the first, the only the first step towards real freedom, towards real progress. So, because the colonialism, Portuguese colonialism, dominated East Timor for 500 years, and it has been proved already that colonialism doesn't serve anybody, doesn't serve any country. So we are quite ready for independence. But of course, we are also quite aware of the backward of our economy, and we would like to have more period, some more time, to work out to a good program, realistic program, with Portuguese government until total independence.
Is this why, in fact, the colonial building in Dili is still there, is untouched, the Portuguese flag is still flying? Would you, in fact, like to see the Portuguese return?
Yes, we still recognize Portuguese government as the only authority in East Timor.
Do you really think that East Timor can be independent when already the larger countries are starting to exert pressure? For example, you have the Australians looking for oil, you have the Japanese building hotels, you have the Indonesians just over the border. Do you really think that you can be independent?
Interdependence of the countries in the world, it is a reality. It's not only small countries that are dependent on the big powers, but nowadays most of the countries are dependent on each other because of economic or military reasons. We cannot run away from this reality. We know that we have to live with the neighboring countries. We know that we are going to have a lot of pressures to manipulate our government.